I got to say to the Delphi community how grateful I am. You inspire people you don't even understand, and you don't even understand why. Information's being released today is the result of literally thousands and thousands of hours of extraordinary investigative efforts by Delphi, Carroll County, the FBI, the Indiana State Police, and countless other agencies. This community surrounded us some 26 months ago, and you did everything you could to support us, but most importantly, you surrounded the family of these two little girls. Gosh, I'll never forget it. After you hear what we're going to release today, I'm going to ask for your continued support, your continued understanding, your empathy and compassion as we move forward to find out who did this, and we will. We're seeking the public's help to identify the driver of a vehicle that was parked at the old CPS DCS welfare building in the city of Delphi that was abandoned on the east side of County Road 300 North next to the Hoosier Heartland Highway between the hours of noon to 5 on February 14th, 2017. If you were parked there or know who was parked there, please contact the officers at the command post at the Delphi City Building. We are releasing additional portions of the audio recording from that day. Please keep in mind, the person talking is one person and is the person on the bridge with the girls. This is not two different people speaking. Please listen to it very, very carefully. We are also releasing video recovered from Libby's phone. This video has never before been previously released. The video shows a suspect walking on the bridge. When you see the video, watch the person's mannerisms as they walk. Watch the mannerisms as he walks. Do you recognize the mannerisms as being someone that you might know? Remember, he is walking on the former railroad bridge. Because of the deteriorated condition of the bridge, the suspect is not walking naturally due to the spacing between the ties. During the course of this investigation, we have concluded the first sketch released will become secondary as of today. The result of the new information and intelligence over time leads us to believe the sketch, which you will see shortly, is the person responsible for the murders of these two little girls. We also believe this person is from Delphi, currently or has previously lived here, visits Delphi on a regular basis, or works here. We believe this person is currently between the age range of 18 and 40, but might appear younger than his true age. Directly to the killer who may be in this room. We believe you are hiding in plain sight. For more than 2 years, you never thought we would shift gears to a different investigative strategy, but we have. We likely have interviewed you or someone close to you. We know that this is about power to you. And you want to know what we know. And one day, you will. A question to you. What will those closest to you think of when they find out that you brutally murdered two little girls? Two children. Only a coward would do such a thing. We are confident that you have told someone what you have done. Or at the very least, they know because of how different you are since the murders. We try so hard to understand how a person could do something like this to two children. I recently watched a movie called The Shack. And there's also a book that talks so well about evil, about death, and about eternity to the murderer. I believe you have just a little bit of a conscience left. And I can assure you that how you left them in that woods is not what they're experiencing today. To the family, I hope that you all will give them some time, because we're going to be asking that there's no media inquiry or no media response for at least the next 2 weeks, and I hope you understand why. The family found out about this information this morning. I just want the family to know that when I take my last breath on this earth, I'll be thinking of them. There's going to be a tremendous amount of questions. I know that. Never in my career have I stood in front of something like this. Please be patient with us. Please. We're just beginning. We are just now beginning. And I can tell you on behalf of the sheriff and the police chief, so many other partners that have stood with us over this period of time, that we will not stop.
I just unveiled the person that we believe responsible for the murder of these two little girls. So I invite media to take a look at that now.
It's not up.
Kim? We're also going to show you a video not previously released that Superintendent spoke to, and also the audio that's additional to what's been previously released. It's only a slight change in it. So give Sergeant Riley just a second as he gets that up and ready. Stand by for the video, please. There is no sound of the video. As Superintendent Carter mentioned, he is on the railway bridge. You have to take different steps to get to it. This information later this afternoon will be on the State Police website. For the community that's here, we have 100 copies of the news release. If you put in that URL, you'll be able to get to that site to play it. And we also have that same release for you in the media. And the rest of the state will get that release in about 15 minutes. So we appreciate those of you that came here. This concludes our announcement. Thank you for your time, patience, and courtesy.